Second topic name called as oblique incidence of plane wave on a thin film due to transmitted light system. Consider ABCD of thin film of thickness T and refractive index mu, and this is enclosed by air medium. Now consider lambda wavelength of plane wave of light which is incidenting on obliquely from P on the upper surface of the film AB at point Q. Now draw a normal on the surface at the point Q. Hence the light ray making an angle I with the normal. Now at point Q, some part of PQ light ray reflected at Q as shown in this animation, and this light ray is making same angle with I. Hence angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Again, if you look into at point Q, then some part of PQ light ray is refracted into the film and incident on the lower surface of the film CD at R. Now this QR light ray is making an angle R with the normal. Similarly, at point R, draw a normal, and this normal is also making the same angle R. The light ray QR at point R, some of the part of light ray is reflected and another part of light ray is transmitted. So at point R, the light ray QR is transmitted and reaches a point S. This RS is making an angle I with the normal. Assume this is the ray 1. Again at point R, the light ray QR is reflected and reaches the point T on the upper surface of the film. Half surface name call it as a AB. This light ray RT is also making an angle R with the normal. Assume this is the light ray 2. This T is an AB surface, draw normal, then it touches the lower surface CD at N. Now here also RT light ray is making an angle R with the normal. Now at point T, some of the part of light ray refracted and remaining another part of light ray is reflected. So at point T, the light ray RT refracted to outside as shown in this animation. This emergent light ray is making an angle I with the normal. Again at T, another part of light ray reflected and reaches the CD lower surface at point U. So this light ray TU is making an angle R with the normal. Assume this light ray TU is also light ray 2. At point U, draw normal. So light ray is also making same an angle R. At point U, some of the part of light ray reflected and another part of light ray is transmitted. So at point U, the light ray TU reflected is as shown in this animation. This reflected light ray also making R angle with the normal. That means inside the film, the angle of light rays with the normal is always R. And at point U, the light ray TU is transmitted and reaches a point V. Hence, this UV light ray is also making an angle I with the normal. Assume this UV light ray is 2. Now draw a line from point U on RS light ray 1 and it reaches perpendicular to a point M. So at point U on the surface of CD and UM line, both are making an angle I. So according to geometry, angle RUM is equal to I. This can be observed in this animation. Angle RTN is equal to R. This can be observed in this animation. And angle TSN is equal to R. This can be observed in this animation. Hence, there exists a path difference in between the light rays 1 and 2. Therefore, path difference delta is equal to light ray 2 traveled in medium minus light ray 1 traveled in air. So, why this equation has came? I will explain very clearly on here. At point R, the reflected light ray 2 undergoes reflections and refractions. So, the light ray 2 traveled a distances in RT, TU and UV. At point R, the refracted light ray 1 reaches the point S. Hence, with respect to light ray 1, the light ray 2 traveled an additional path RT and TU. Similarly, with respect to light ray 2, the light ray 1 traveled an additional path RM. From this analogy, we can write as path difference between the light rays 1 and 2 as delta is equal to RT plus TU, the distance traveled in medium, minus RM, the distance traveled in air. In the above statement, the first term, that is RT plus TU, the distance traveled in medium, since it is traveled in medium, hence the above equation can be written as delta is equal to mu into RT plus TU minus RM. That implies delta is equal to 2 mu RT minus RM. Since RT and TU are equal, therefore RT is equal to TU. So from triangle RUM, we can write as sin I is equal to RM by RU. That we can write as RM is equal to RU sin I. Hence the side equation can be written as RM is equal to 2 into RN sin I. Assume this is first equation. Since the above equation can be written as from RN is equal to NU. This is shown in this animation. But according to Snell's law, mu is equal to sin I by sin R. This equation can be written as sin I is equal to mu sin R. Put sin I value in one equation. Therefore, RM is equal to 2 mu RN sin R. Assume this is second equation. So, but from the triangle RTN, cos R is equal to TN by RT implies RT is equal to TN by cos R. Therefore, we can write the equation as RT is equal to T by cos R. Here, TN means the thickness of the film, which is T. Assume this is third equation. Also from this same triangle RTN, we can write as tan R is equal to RN by TN. That is, we can write as RN is equal to TN tan R implies RN is equal to T into tan R. Assume this is fourth equation. So substitute second, third and fourth in the path difference equation. So the path difference equation is delta is equal to 2 mu RT minus RM. So substitute these path difference equation in 2, 3 and 4, then we can write as delta is equal to 2 mu into T by cos R minus 2 mu into sin R into T into tan R is equal to 2 mu T by cos R into 1 minus sin square R. Simplify this equation. So we will get delta is equal to 2 mu T by cos R into cos square R. Here, 1 cos R will get cancelled. Therefore, path difference delta is equal to 2 mu T cos R. Assume this is fifth equation. So, this equation is called the cosine law. Moreover, this equation meant for transmitted light system. Hence, the condition for brightness, especially 1 and 2 light rays, is delta is equal to 2 mu t cos r is equal to n lambda. Here n is equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma so on. Assume this is 6th equation. So the condition for darkness is delta is equal to 2 mu t cos r is equal to 2 n plus 1 into lambda by 2. Here n is equal to 0 comma 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma so on. Assume this is 7th equation. So this gives the short description of reflected light system and also transmitted light system. So this is our topic. So please subscribe our Telugu Gamanam channel for more lecture videos. Click the bell icon for notifications. If you want to get lecture notes for this lecture video, click the description link below in the lecture video. Thank you for watching this video. See you again in the next lecture video. Have a nice day. Thank you one and all.